Hello everybody, welcome to this video. So in this video I'm going to show you how to use Icue version 4.12 on your computer and how to customize the G keys on your Corsair keyboard. So what I'm going to do now is that I'm going to click on software, and by the way this website will be in the description of my video, so just one click on it and you should open it. So once you open it, I want you to click on software. Then from here, I want you to click on download software, and right here, choose last version, which is 4.12. And I'm going to click on this arrow down. So when I do that, it will show me this form, and I'm not gonna enter my information here. I'm gonna just click on skip right here. So just one click on it, and it should be downloaded. So once it's downloaded, you'll need to double click on it and just install it just like any other application. And then you'll need to click on yes, and I'm going to close this browser now because we no longer need it. And right here it will show you the wizard, so just click on next. And right here you'll need to click on next and just wait for the setup to finish. So once it says congratulations, installation successful, you can click on finish. And now I'm going to click on start. And I should see the Icue up there. So I'm going to right click on it. And I'm going to click on more. And run as administrator. Then click on yes. You should see your keyboard right here. So this is the Icue software. And this is your keyboard. So one click on it. So what I want you to do is that I want you to click on key assignments. So if you have used a previous version, you should see your recorded macros. And if you didn't, you should see something like this. So this area should be empty. So what you'll need to do to create a new macro is you'll need to click on plus here. And once you click on plus, it will show you the assignment type. So for example, you can choose keystroke or language keys or whatever you want. So I'm going to click on keystroke. So once you select the assignment type, it will show you the key. And this is the key here. So you notice that you have some G keys right here. And they are empty keys. Select a key, for example, I'm going to choose G1. And I have my G1 here. Then I'm going to type my key, which is W. So I want to press W. And you'll notice that W will be selected here. So now, whenever I press G1 on my keyboard, it will represent that I'm pressing W. And now, just to show you what I mean by that, is that I'm going to open Notepad, and I'm going to press G1. And as I press it, it types letter W. So that's one thing we can do about it. And let's change it to something else. So I'm going to click on keyboard instead of keystroke. And right here, you'll notice that this is the keyboard, and I can press W, you know, just like that. So this is the same thing, except if I click on W here, for example, if I choose W here, and if I click on advanced, you'll notice that I can enable imitate holding key. So if I enable this, you'll notice that it will say on press and stop in 0.1. So what I want to do now here is that whenever I press G1, I want it to imitate as if I'm holding the W key down. So I'm going to change on press to toggle. So now it's toggle. So now I'm going back to my notepad, and if I press G1, you'll notice nothing is happening because we have not assigned it. So I'm going to click on G1. And as you notice right here, it says keyboard 1, G1. So let me just make sure that I have chosen W here. So W is selected. All right. So we have it there. It's highlighted. And I'm going to go to advance. My toggle. So I changed it to toggle. So now it should work. So now if I press G1, you'll notice that so it keeps typing W. And if I press G1 now, it will stop. So this is one action that you can, you know, assign to your G keys. And right here, you'll notice that it says keyboard 1, G1. So if you click on it, this is the assignment type here. And this is the key that you change. So in this case, it's G1. And what happens is I have clicked on W, all right? And from there, I have clicked on advanced, and then I just enabled imitate holding key. I just enabled it by clicking on this slider. And then I just changed this one to toggle. So now that's basically it. And also I want to talk about macros. So a macro is a set of actions that you can assign to a specific key. So for example, I'm going to click on plus to create a new assignment. And right here, I have my assignment here. And right here, I'm going to choose macro. And when I click on that, it will show me the key. So now I'll choose, for example, G5. And I see G5 here. But right now, I see a record button here. And I have a macro. So when I click on record, it's going to record everything that I'm doing on my keyboard. So I'm going to click on it and I'm going to say hello world, all right? And then I'm going to click on pause or stop. So now you'll notice that we have an action there. And now if I go to my notepad and if I press G5, you'll notice that it will type hello world. So if I press that again, it will just retype that. All right. So one more time, just press it and it types it there. So that's basically it about macros. So if you want to re-record a macro, what you can do is that you can click on these three dots here and then just click on delete all events. So if you do that, it will delete everything. But before I click on delete all events, I want to talk about this option, which is delete all delays. So if you click on it, it will just remove all of the delays. So now if I go to notepad and if I press G5, you'll notice that it types that in without any delays. All right. So that's something maybe that can help you in some way. And you can click on general for some other things. So if you want to enable mouse clicks, for example, you can just click on this bar and it will include the mouse clicks, and you can enable mouse wheel scroll, mouse movement. You can do all of that stuff. So now I hope that you have a basic idea about how to use Icue software on your computer. And if you have any questions, please leave them below in the comments and I will answer them. And don't forget to support my channel by subscribing to my channel. So thank you all for watching and I will see you all in the next video.